reports of mass evacuations from the area surrounding a nuclear power plant as an explosion destroys a building that houses a reactor. And we get reports of some type of emergency at a second reactor in that same complex. This as Japan is rocked just moments ago by another aftershock, this one measuring 6.3, about 80 miles from that nuclear plant. Greg Palcott is streaming live for us from Ōrai, Japan. Greg.
Hey, Rick, we're about 75 miles north of Tokyo, and here on this Sunday morning, people here are getting to grips with the crisis, with the catastrophe that has hit this part of the country. All around me, we can see cars, boats, trucks that have been thrown around by the tsunami wave that reached inland from this port city. Also, we've been seeing, as we've been traveling around the country, the effect of the earthquake itself. Cracks in roads, buildings damaged as well. The death toll, Rick, continues to climb. Officially put somewhere between 1,300 and 1,700, but we've been speaking to locals, and there are tens of thousands of people are missing, and so that death toll expected to climb. Also, this whole area, as we've been driving around, kind of a dead zone in other ways. Electricity is out, water is out, a real problem for the people here. A lot of people are leaving. As you noted too, Rick, the real concern about 75 miles further up north the coast, the Fukushima nuclear plant. That has been the scene of damage caused by Friday's quake. The cooling system of that plant has been damaged. Yesterday, we saw an explosion. We saw a release of radioactivity, and there's about a 12-mile exclusion zone around that plant right now. We're seeing evacuations. The real concern is a serious meltdown. Relief efforts are now kicking in. About 50,000 Japanese troops are involved. We've been seeing helicopters going over us right now, and the international community getting involved. The 7th Fleet is getting involved. The Ronald Reagan aircraft carrier is steaming in this direction, as well as other ships. The international community pitching in this effort, which is now a race against time, Rick. This country has seen earthquakes a lot, seen even tsunamis a lot, but they haven't seen anything quite like this. I haven't seen anything quite like this either, except for one time, and that was that huge tsunami. In the next days, we'll be moving closer into the area, and the scenes there, absolute devastation. One more note here. Sunday morning, you might be hearing sirens in the background. I'm looking at the local school here, smoke coming from that school, a fire there. It is a place where refugees have been coming and sheltering. Might be even more problems for the people here in Japan that have been feeling a lot of woes right in the last couple of days, Rick.
Greg, you mentioned that a lot of people are leaving or trying to. Where are they going?
Well, this is the problem, Rick, because the roads are wiped out. Transportation is very difficult. Traffic jams backing up. There are shelters further inland. Again, we are here along the coast where the good bulk of the damage has occurred, but they are moving away. We entered, of course, this area through Tokyo. Tokyo took a lot of hits, but it is a functioning metropolis. It is able to absorb some of the folks that can leave this embattled area right now. Right now, this place is in bad, bad shape, Rick.
Greg Palcott is live for us in the northeastern part of Japan. Ōrai is the name of the city. Greg, thanks very much.